Okay, so today we're going to do an experiment with our scuppernongs that we picked and see if we can make some wine with just sugar and water and a little bit of thyme. We had about 10 gallons. We've taken some out to crush in a separate container so that we can fill our jars and our fermentation containers and all that other good stuff. We've got about 5 cups of sugar in a gallon of water to make it a sweet wine. We have taken out enough scuppernongs to fill our containers about halfway. Just depends on what size containers you want to use. Alright, so what I've got here is a gallon of water on the stove with 5 cups of sugar inside, and you just want to get this up to temp until it boils a little bit. Just make sure that everything is dissolved. If you use the regular white sugar, it should come clear. We use one that's not quite as bleached, so it'll have a little bit of a tannish color to it, but that's perfectly normal. There's nothing wrong with it. It's just sugar water. Alright, so pro tip, use a canning funnel. Makes everything a lot easier, a lot cleaner. But we're just putting the crushed up scuppernongs in our container. It's got a little spigot on the bottom. It should be easier to get everything out. In theory, but we've never done this before, so we'll see.
So the container's about half full, and you see we still got this left in here, so I might throw some of this juice in there, but we've been doing a lot of experimenting this year. We're going to see how this works out. And the reason why we're not going to put your sugar water in here hot, because, and I have no evidence to back this up, but I think if we were to put it in there hot, it would kill off all the good yeast, all the good bacteria and such that normally ferments items, that I don't want to do that. So wait for the sugar water to cool down. That's how we're going to try it. We think it's worth mentioning that where these came from was a friend of the family, and we know they use no pesticides. If you're not sure, please rinse them really well and wash them really well. Use your own discretion. Well, they are extremely juicy, and look how beautiful this is. This is one scuppernong. That is absolutely stunning. Most of them are about like this. We have a few that are smaller, but as you can see, that's average size, and you may want to wear some kind of glasses, because these little suckers will throw juice in your eyeballs. But this is just what we're doing, because I don't have, oh, it just got me. We don't have a juicer or anything like that. This is my juicer. This is my juicer container. And look at all that juice. Now, even though these right here have a different color, these are all scuppernongs. Your purple ones are muscadines, and that's usually what people make the jelly out of and wine out of and things like that. You can do it with these. We like scuppernongs. But again, these are scuppernongs. And the purple ones are muscadines. Okay, since we kind of got pick happy and got 2 5-gallon buckets, and we didn't have any plans for them, and I already have too much jelly, and we're going to use 1 whole 5-gallon bucket to experiment with the wine. The other 5-gallon bucket right here, what I'm doing is I'm draining it into this one that's just catching water because it's empty. I'm going to freeze these. So that if this works, we can do some more wine later if we like it. If not, we can turn around and she can use it for her kombucha. We can make more jelly if somebody decides they want some, or I'm short on Christmas gifts, or somebody just likes scuppernongs.
Alrighty, so we filled our first 1/2-gallon jar with the cooled off sugar syrup solution. I'm going to do 1/2 of the 1/2-gallon jars with a coffee filter and 1/2 of them with an actual lid and ring. And we're just writing the date on the coffee filter so we remember when we did this. Alrighty, so we have everything now mixed together all in one little area. We have 3 of these 1-gallon containers that all have a spigot. We have 4 1/2-gallon jars. One of them has a coffee filter lid. The other 3 are completely sealed off with the metal band and ring. These down here have a spigot, so just in case they leak, we have a little container here. The rest of them, in case they bubble, are in a little container as well. I tasted the juice that was mixed with the sugar water from one of the little gallon jars with the spigot. It is amazing, and if it tastes anything like that, with a hint of alcohol, I think this is how we're gonna do things from now on. We used 5 gallons of the 10 gallons that we had. We went ahead and took the others and put them in gallon-sized Ziploc freezer bags so that we can use them at a later date, because they will not keep very well in the fridge or on the counter or anything like that. So I hope you guys enjoyed. If you have any questions, comments, or even suggestions for more things to do with scuppernongs, just let us know in the comment section down below, and I'll talk to you guys later. Bye!